Because you know who I ultimately blame for all of this? I blame LeBron James. It's all his fault. It's all his fault, okay? First of all, you go to it is hypocritical of me because even though I didn't like what happened, it was in South Beach. So why would I complain about having to go to South Beach? I mean, come on now. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just throwing myself out on Front Street and that. I got it. But remember when they won the championship in Cleveland? And then the next year he came back. You had D-Wade to the mix. You had Deron Williams to the mix as well. You tried to do something like that in order to repeat as champions. KD ultimately hijacks your run because what does he do? He goes to Golden State, and now he's one up to there. And then he won back-to-back titles. Should have won three. Would have had a three-peat had he not torn his Achilles. Would have easily had a three-peat without question, okay? But then after that, what happens? Now he comes to Brooklyn, and this is what he's doing. Thank God there's some level of competition because, see, that's the biggest thing. When I was appeared with KD on the Boardroom on this show on ESPN Plus from before, when I appeared on there, okay, what I explained was it's all about competition. I'm old school, man. I grew up watching the NBA. I've been covering the NBA for 27 years. I've been watching it all my life pretty much. I love the NBA, and I love competition. And you want to see people wanting to go against one another. And there's this culture where everybody's trying to join one another. And that goes against everything that I'm about. And I think that KD was definitely more significant because you joined a juggernaut. What, they had won 73 games, and you joined a juggernaut.
But what Magic really showed these dudes is –
Magic?
Yeah, oh, excuse me. LeBron really showed. I'm going to talk about Magic in a second. What LeBron really showed these dudes, including KD, is that we can do the same thing the teams are doing. Because I think the reason I said Magic is I think about the Lakers in 79-80. That's Magic's rookie year, right? It's him and Kareem.
Okay.
And,
but they drafted Worthy.
I'm not talking about Worthy, though.
Okay.
I'm talking about Jamal Wilkes. And I'm talking about...
He was already on the squad, right?
Norm Nixon, right.
Nixon was already there.
That's right. And then they trade for Spencer Haywood, right?
Yeah, but my point is, it was draft, though.
Okay. My point is what LeBron showed the world and other players like KD is, you see the way the teams are the boss and the GMs put together? Because the Lakers had a super-duper team. Stephen A., did they need Spencer Haywood? Like, they needed to grab an all-star power forward to go with all-time great center. They didn't need to do it. But they did it. And what LeBron showed KD is we can do that too. I'm going to take Chris Bosh. Me and Wade and Chris Bosh are going to do it. KD said, bet. I'll just go and join Golden State. Oh, those aren't the rules? Bet. I'll make my own team. Me, Kyrie, and Harden. What's the difference between him doing that and a GM doing that in L.A.?
I understand that. But what I'm trying to tell you is that the players themselves are the ones on the court competing. I'm not saying that the GMs, the executives don't compete out there. And I'm not faulting Sean Marks, who I think is doing an outstanding job. And I'm not faulting the Brooklyn Nets. I don't blame you. You could be all over me if I was doing that. I would do the same thing if I was them. LaMarcus Aldridge and Blake Griffin gave up about $20 million to get there, okay? They gave up about $20 million to end up on the roster.
An expensive ring.
There we go.
They're buying an expensive ring.
They're buying a ring. But what I'm saying is I'm not knocking Sean Marks, Steve Nash, Mike D'Antoni. I'm not knocking an organization. That's what you're trying to do. The players themselves, you are on the court competing, and I had five players text me this weekend. Oh, that's what we're doing now, Stephen A?
It's anti-competitive, basically.
Because they're saying it's anti-competitive. They're like, you can guess who some of those are.
Both
they're like this.
Salty.
They text me. That's what we're doing now, Stephen A. That's what I'm saying.
Kawhi didn't go to the Lakers. Kawhi tried to compete against LeBron.
Yeah, no, I might have to rethink Kawhi. Because
speaking of the number five.
Yeah.
The Nets have five players with at least five All-Star appearances, so that's pretty incredible. Only the Celtics did that back, that 2010 squad. There's five players on the Nets with at least five All-Star appearances. Only one other team in history that did that, and that was that stacked Celtics squad back in the day, 2010-2011.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.